let me welcome you once again to this exciting morning. This is the day the Lord has made, and it is for you and I to rejoice and be glad in it. Abraham is our father, and he is called the father of faith. And what we are studying in Genesis 22 is a practical example why he earned that title, and we shall honor him in that place. We are studying the pathway to the blessing, the pathway to the blessing. We all want to be blessed, but we need to pay attention to how our father arrived at that blessing. Let's recap it once again. First of all, he was in the right place to hear from God. Secondly, when the Lord called him, he answered. Thirdly, when he received the instruction, though bizarre, he obeyed. Let's pick up the story. The Bible says, verse 3 once again, and Abraham rose up early in the morning and saddled his ass. No hesitation. That's the way you do it, beloved. The moment the Lord speaks to you, you just obey it. They've said that delayed obedience is actually disobedience. When we start hesitating and now we need 2 and 3 confirmations, beloved, that's because we don't want to do it. Because if the same voice or the same ministry comes to us that somebody's going to bless us with finances or whatever, we just believe it and start celebrating and even start discussing it with other people. Let's not fake ourselves out, because we really cannot fake God out. Amen. If you want the blessing, then get serious with the sacrifice necessary. So Abraham got up, took his 2 young men with him, and Isaac his son, and clave the wood for the burnt offering, and rose up and went unto the place which God had told him. He just obeyed. I pray that you will obey today. Whatever the Lord has spoken to you, please obey. Go do it today. Go act on it today. Then you will be on your way to the blessing. You'll be on your way to your breakthrough. You'll be on your way to your miracle. That's the way the kingdom is configured. If I had not taken my savings and sown it, beloved, this church would not be here today. But I did it, and God said, now, get up and start the ministry. Start having services. He told me where to go. He worked it all out. And today, the rest is history. The Bible says in verse 4 of Genesis 22, then on the 3rd day, Abraham lifted up his eyes and saw the place afar off. He had to walk 3 days to get to the site of the sacrifice. What a sacrifice. What a determination. You are, beloved, you know that the enemy would have been talking to him, messing with his mind, trying to get him to turn around or change his mind. He had 1,000 times, you know, so many opportunities to look at Isaac and to ask himself, am I really ready to sacrifice my only son for God or to God? Think about such a low level of sacrifice that the children of God are operating in today. We grumble loudly every time we have to do something out of the ordinary. And we bring up scriptures, we talk about balance, and we talk about this and that and the other. Will we be able to pass this test to receive the blessing? Beloved, consider the authentic pathway to blessing. It is littered with sacrifice, but such unique sacrifice that only God can command you directly. No man can bring such a word to you. You will reject it. Amen. He said they walked for 3 days, and Abraham saw the place afar off. Now watch this. And Abraham said unto his young men, abide ye here with the ass, and I and the lad will go yonder and worship and come again to you. Amen, beloved. You need to face this area. There are places nobody can go with you. If you look at what happened when Jesus was making up his mind to go to the cross for us, he went with the 12, and then he left them at a location. Then he went with the three, the inner circle, and went to a different location. And then he went further than that to encounter the Lord. Yes. Abraham said, all right, guys, you have come as far as you can go. I've seen the place where God has commanded. I and the lad will go up and worship. And now listen to his faith, and we will come again. We will go and worship and come again. Why would he say that, beloved? Isaac was the promise. There's no way Isaac would die. God said, through him, I will bless the generations. Hallelujah. This is the promised son. That's why Abraham believed that even if it was necessary, God will raise him from the dead. Wow. Do we have such confidence? Do we have such repose in the Lord? Are we so certain of his word, his promise, that we will obey him in sacrifice so we can receive that blessing? These are the questions you need to be answering. These are the promises God has made us. And many of us are overloaded with promises, but we haven't been able to cash in into any of them. Why? Because when the sacrifice comes, you chicken out. Are you on your pathway to the blessing? Or have you parked somewhere murmuring and complaining? I pray that this word this week will challenge you and cause you to return to the Lord. And you will be blessed. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. God bless you.
The Lord is waiting on you.
Yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is.